Hello friends, in previous video we have studied what are the various short circuit tests that are conducted on the circuit breaker. So basically short circuit tests are conducted to check the total capability of the circuit breaker. Also these tests are conducted for the research and development purpose. Now what are the various plants that are used where the testing is done will be studied in this video. So let us study what are the various short circuit plants for the short circuit test. Introduction. Now basically there are three types of testing stations. First is field type testing station. Second is laboratory type testing station. Third is composite type testing station. So these are the three testing stations which are used for the short circuit test. So let us study field type of testing. Now in the field type of testing, the power required for the testing can be taken directly from the large power system, and the breaker to be tested is directly connected to the system. Next is laboratory type of testing. So in case of laboratory type of testing, short circuit generators are provided for the power testing. Therefore, the breaker can be tested either directly or indirectly. So the short circuit generators which are provided, they will provide the short circuit voltage for the testing of the circuit breaker. When the breaking capacity of the test plant is inadequate, then to test the breaker, indirect test can be performed which will assess the behavior of the circuit breaker. So there are two types of test which come under the laboratory type. First is direct test and second is indirect test. Now in case of direct test, directly the short circuit generator is connected to the circuit breaker to create the short circuit conditions. But suppose the voltage of the short circuit generator is not sufficient for testing of the circuit breaker, then in that case indirect testing can be done. So there are several indirect methods of testing, such as first is substitution method, second is unit testing, third is synthetic testing, next is composite testing. So in case of composite testing, it is a combination of the field type testing and laboratory type testing station. Now let us see the layout of the simple short circuit testing station. First point, description of the simple test plant. So figure shows the schematic diagram for the short circuit test plant. Let us see this. So here these are the various test cells, then these are the short circuit transformers. Here we have the mix switch, then there is one reactor, there is one resistor, then the most important component, that is a master circuit breaker. One impulse exciter is needed, then there is one drive motor which is coupled to the short circuit generator. And here there is the neutral grounding. Now the master circuit breaker is connected so that if the circuit breaker which is to be tested undergoes certain failure and it will not operate, then in that case the master circuit breaker will protect the complete system. So the short circuit power is supplied by the specially built short circuit generator. There are normally two or more generators, but in figure only one generator is considered for simplicity. Now the short circuit generators are driven by the three-phase induction motor and the special type of excitation which is called as impulse excitation. Let us see this in the figure. So if we see here, this is our short circuit generator which will create the short circuit conditions for the testing of the circuit breaker. Now this short circuit generator is driven by the drive motor and impulse exciter. Also, series resistors or reactors are provided for adjusting the magnitude of short circuit current and the power factor. Whatever short circuit current is generated by the short circuit generator, for adjustment of its current and the power factor, resistors and reactors are connected in series. Also, the master circuit breaker having the higher capacity than the circuit breaker under the test is connected. In case of the failure of the circuit breaker under the test, the master circuit breaker will open and protect the circuit. So for the preventive measures, master circuit breaker is connected, which is having the higher capacity as compared to the circuit breaker under test. Now the make switch is a specially designed switch for closing device, which can close at the desired moment and can withstand the making currents. Also, transformers are used to get the test voltage other than the generated voltage. The transformers are single phase units which can be connected in different ways for the several tests. So whatever short circuit voltage is generated by the generator, it is provided to the required level by using the transformer. Suppose if the circuit breaker that is connected for testing is operated for a particular test that requires the lower value of voltage as per generated by the short circuit generator, then the step down transformer can be used. If the voltage level is to be increased, then the step up transformer can be used. According to the requirement of the voltage by the circuit breaker under the test, the transformer is adjusted. Now, in addition to the above experiment, there are certain equipments such as measuring, recording and controlling equipment, then sequence switch to obtain the sequential operation. Now the sequence switch is very important. It will decide what is the proper sequence of the operation of the test. Next are the auxiliaries. Now let us study the short circuit generator and drive motor. Now the short circuit generator will provide power to the circuit breaker under the test. So whatever circuit breaker is connected, it has to be tested for its complete capabilities. So the main operation of the circuit breaker is understood at the short circuit conditions. So in order to test whether the circuit breaker operates properly under the short circuit conditions, the short circuit generator is connected that will create the short circuit condition. So this generator should be designed in such a way that it must be capable of withstanding extremely high reactive power surges which might last for a short duration. Therefore, their design is different from the conventional generators. The generator is driven by the three-phase induction motor which is connected through the resilient shaft. Now we know that generator converts mechanical energy to electrical energy. So it requires something that will provide the mechanical energy. So the three-phase induction motor is used, which will convert electrical energy to mechanical energy. This mechanical energy is coupled to the generator, so it will act as the input. It will take the input as a mechanical energy and convert it into electrical power, which is fed to the circuit breaker under test. Now, shortly before the short circuit, the motor is disconnected from the supply and it comes to rest with generator. So a special DC converter set with the high speed output called as impulse excitation is provided. So let us study the demagnetizing effect of the short circuit. Now the short circuit current, which is at the lagging power factor, will have a certain demagnetizing effect. So because of the demagnetizing effect, it will try to demagnetize the magnetic circuit, so there will be reduction in the flux. This will lead in the reduction of the total field and hence the reduced EMF. As a result, the recovery voltage is less than the voltage before the short circuit. So this effect of the demagnetizing of the short circuit can be reduced by boosting the generator field current by using the impulse excitation. So the main aim of the impulse excitation is to boost the generator field current so that the demagnetizing effect of the short circuit can be reduced. So the converter set used for the excitation is fitted with a large flywheel. The motor is disconnected from the supply before the application of excitation. So before we have to apply the impulse excitation, the motor should be disconnected from the supply. By use of the excitation, the field current is increased shortly by 10 times its normal value at the time of short circuit. This will take care of the demagnetization effect of the short circuit and it will provide the desired recovery voltage. Next is short circuit transformer. So for the test, at voltages other than the generated voltage, transformers are used. As I have already told you, there are various tests which are conducted on the circuit breaker. Each test might require the different level of voltages, but the voltage that is generated by the generator is fixed. So to vary this voltage, as per the requirement of the circuit breaker, transformer is connected. So to step down the voltage to the lower values, a three-phase transformer is normally used. For the voltages required higher than the generated voltage, the single-phase transformer bank are used. These transformers are designed to withstand repeated short circuit and their windings have several parts which can be connected in series or parallel combination to get the several voltages. Now the leakage reactance of the short circuit transformer has to be kept low. Also, the transformer winding should be mechanically strong and it should be provided with extra turn insulation. Now this transformer will be used to provide the voltage for the short circuit testing of the circuit breaker. As a result, it will be continuously having the mechanical as well as electrical stresses. So the transformers which are used should be designed accordingly to sustain such stresses. Now instead of three-phase units, generally single-phase banks are used. The reason behind this is that three-phase units are not used because a single three-phase unit becomes too big. So the space requirement is reduced by using the single-phase banks. Also, there is no special problem for cooling because these transformers are in circuit only for a short period of time. So the cooling arrangement is not required. Therefore, for three-phase test, transformer connected in delta on the alternator side or the generator side. The four windings on each phase on the secondary side can be connected either in series or parallel combination, and the three phases can be connected either in star or in delta. Next is reactors. For cooling the short circuit currents, the reactors are used. They can be either air core type or air cool type. So the iron parts are avoided in their construction. So while constructing the reactors, iron parts are avoided. These are single phase units or three phase banks. Now each reactor is designed to withstand the electrodynamic stress. As the reactor is used for the cooling purpose of the short circuit current, they will undergo several electrodynamic stresses. So whatever reactor is connected, it should be designed to sustain the high value of electrodynamic stress. So the coils are securely placed to avoid the distortion. Next important part is the master circuit breaker. This type of circuit breaker is mostly air blast type, of having capacity more than the breaker under the test. So in case of failure of the test circuit breaker, the master circuit breaker will open and it will protect the system. In addition to this, after every test, it has to isolate the specimen under the test from the supply source, and it must be able to handle full short circuit power of the test circuit breaker. Next is making device. So the making device or the making switch is used to ensure that short circuit currents are applied correctly at the desired moment. So the equipment is characterized by close making time and high making capacity. However, the breaker capacity is negligible and the making device is not used for the circuit interruption. So the basic construction of the making switch is as follows. It is basically air blast making switch with air pressure of 15 to 16 kgf per centimeter square. Also, the contact clearance of few mm is sufficient for the contact device as it is very fast. Now in recent years, instead of air blast type, SF6 type make fuses are also used. Next part is capacitor. Now the capacitor banks are useful for two purposes. First is, it will provide the leading current for testing the performance of the circuit breaker in the interruption of the charging current. And second is for the regulation of frequency of the transient recovery voltage. And next use is for regulating the frequency of the transient recovery voltage, which is given by Fn is equal to 1 upon 2 pi root of Lc. Now the capacitor banks provided, they will give us the charging currents, then regulate the natural frequency of transient voltage and are used for the synthetic testing. These are the single phase banks. They can be connected either in series or parallel as required, both individually or in any combination. Next part is resistors. So the variation of the short circuit power can be obtained by using the resistors in series with the reactors. So the power factor can be increased from 0.1 to 0.3. Next is test cubicle. So the test cubicle is constructed of reinforced cement, concrete or strong brickwork, because inside the test cubicle the test circuit breaker is placed. In this test cubicle, circuit breaker is tested. Now there is a provision for observation. Supply of the compressed air and the oil purification system is given to the test cell so as to facilitate testing of air blast circuit breaker or oil circuit breaker. Next is sequence switch. Now during the short circuit testing, several operations are performed in a sequence and the total time is too short to perform the manual operation. So the sequence switch will decide what is the proper sequence of each and every operation. So the sequential switching of equipment measurement and the control is accompanied by sequence switch. There is a drum switch. So sequence switch is basically a drum switch with the several pair of contacts. This drum is rotated by a motor. Once the drum is rotated, it will close and will open the several control circuits according to the sequence. Now let us consider one example. So the sequence for the braking capacity test are as follows. First, drive motor of the short circuit generator is made off, that is the induction motor is turned off. Impulse excitation is turned on. Then the master circuit breaker is closed so that supply goes to the test circuit breaker. Oscillograph circuit is connected to measure all the parameters. Then make switch is closed. Circuit breaker under the test is opened. Now, once the circuit breaker under the test is opened, the master breaker should open. Excitation is switched off and its field is suppressed. All these operations take place in a very short time of about 0.2 seconds. So all these operations are specified by the sequence switch, which will decide the sequence of operation. Next is measurement. Now the test events which were mentioned earlier have covered very short time. So this test occur in very short time. So all the measurements must therefore be recorded by the means of oscillograph. So light beam oscillograph, which are simple to operate and are used for relatively slow varying quantities like current, voltage, and also for the mechanical quantities such as constant travel, trip signal are used. So high frequency transient phenomena of transient recovery voltage will cover very short time interval, which is of the order of just 1 millisecond. So for recording such a fast varying quantity, cathode ray oscilloscope is used. So let us see what are the quantities that are recorded during the test. First is short circuit current in each phase. Second, voltage across each pole before, during, and after the short circuit. Next, fluid pressure. Fluid is nothing but the medium which is used for the arc extinction. Contact travel speed, generator voltage, transient recovery voltage, current in trip circuit. So all these parameters have to be measured during the test. So in this way, we have studied the short circuit testing plant, which is required for conducting various short circuit tests. Thank you friends for watching this video. Stay tuned with eKida and do subscribe our channel eKida. Thank you.